Shrish, it is extremely difficult to proceed toward God while leading the life of a householder. Master, why so? What about the yoga of practice? At Kamarpukur, I have seen the women of the carpenter families selling flattened rice. Let me tell you how alert they are while doing their business. The pestle of the husking machine that flattens the paddy constantly falls into the hole of the mortar. The woman turns the paddy in the hole with one hand and with the other holds her baby on her lap as she nurses it. In the meantime, customers arrive. The machine goes on pounding the paddy and she carries on her bargains with the customers. She says to them, "Pay the few pennies you owe me before you take anything more." You see, she has all these things to do at the same time. Nurse the baby, turn the paddy as the pestle pounds it, take the flattened rice out of the hole and talk to the buyers. This is called the yoga of practice. 15 parts of a mind out of 16 are fixed on the pestle of the husking machine, lest it should pound her hand. With only one part of her mind, she nurses the baby and talks to the buyers. Likewise, he who leads the life of a householder should devote 15 parts of his mind to God. Otherwise, he will face ruin and fall into the clutches of death. He should perform the duties of the world with only one part of his mind. A man may lead the life of a householder after attaining knowledge, but he must attain knowledge first. If the milk of the mind is kept in the water of the world, they get mixed. Therefore, he should turn the milk into curd and extract butter from it by churning it in solitude. Then he may keep the butter in the water of the world. Therefore, you see, spiritual discipline is necessary. When the Ashwatha tree is a mere sapling, it must be enclosed by a fence. Otherwise, the cattle will eat it. But the fence may be taken away when the trunk grows thick and strong. Then even an elephant tied to the tree cannot harm it. Therefore, at the beginning, the aspirant should go into solitude now and then. Spiritual discipline is necessary. You want to eat rice. Suppose you sit down somewhere and say, "Wood contains fire, and fire cooks rice." Can saying it cook the rice? You must get two pieces of wood and by rubbing them together, bring out the fire. By eating siddhi, one becomes intoxicated and feels happy. But suppose you haven't eaten the stuff or done anything else with it. You simply sit down somewhere and mutter, Siddhi, Siddhi. Will that intoxicate you or make you happy? You may learn a great deal from books, but it is all futile if you have no love for God and no desire to realize Him. A mere pandit without discrimination and renunciation has his attention fixed on woman and gold. The vulture soars very high, but its eyes are fixed on the charnel pit.